Hello and welcome by the Orchid Saga. Today I want to do a repot or an upotting with this beautiful tiny orchid. It's just this is the size of it. Maybe get a little bit bigger, but I think this is about it. About the size of the plant, and I'm talking about my Promea Sunlight. I hope you can see that. Whoops. My camera doesn't want to pick it up, but it's Promea Sunlight. And the reason for a upotting is, first of all, here we have some roots who are even growing out over the outer pot. Three new growths there, on the edge of the pot. And I'm not sure, I don't see much new growth here, but these are really pushed to the edge of the pot as well. So I think it's time to give this a new home. I probably might divide it in two pieces. I'm not completely sure because it grows two directions, that way and that way. That's a little bit inconvenient because of the upbudding. But last year, maybe in the beginning of this year, I did a repot it already because I had someone who liked a piece of this plant. So I did a division of it. But I can repot it again because it's really growing well. We have a beautiful new growth here as well. So yeah, let's have a look. I have my camera placed in a bit of a different direction, so I hope this works. I have ordered a external microphone, so that will give me the ability to move around, and you will still hear me quite clear. That at least that's the plan. But I don't have it yet, so I need to be kind of close up to the camera so you can hear me. But that is for in the near future. Near future, okay. So let's have a look at this plant. I hope I'm nicely in screen. I think I am. Try to get it carefully out of its pot because of this beautiful new roots. And I can see two of them are there. They looked right off, but I did break the tips of them when I checked this orchid, I think about 3 days ago. And then I decided I need to repot this now because I see a lot of new root growth, and I will take advantage of that. But it also has a beautiful root inside of the pot. I hope I can save them as well. And I see a lot of new growth in this area of the plant. A little less here, but yeah, before I decide what to do with it. Yeah, we have even, roots coming out of the bottom of the pot. I do not really like this repotting because of the roots. I know I will put it up in the same setup, but still, we always need to sacrifice some roots, and that's why I don't like it. But I think it needs to be done, and I really like the moss in this pot as well. So yeah, well, okay, here we go. Let's take it out carefully. As carefully as I can. Gently, yes. And it's tiny, so I can not really hold it very well. Let me see. There we go. So I think that did go kind of well. Okay, well, we have quite some roots, so in that case I could make this an upotting because it has roots all the way down to the edge of the pot, the bottom of the pot, I'm sorry. Because when it only have roots like so far in a pot, and it's a wide growing orchid, I do not like to put them up because the pots only get even larger and deeper. But this one likes to make quite some roots, so therefore I might just put it up in a bigger pot. Let me see what kind of pots I have, and I will be right back to you guys. Okay, and I am back. I just opened this closet here, and the first thing I saw, and I didn't remember that I had it, I should have, but I just opened a closet and this is what I saw, these net pots. And as you can see, they are not very deep but very wide, but and I found these, who I think go well with this. I think this is a nice setup for the cell watering, but I never used them. And these are, like I said, quite wide, so this orchid, if it's placed correctly in the middle and it likes this setup, it can probably grow on for quite some years in this. What I did, I just used this as a measurement, and you can see this pot goes in completely. And that's beautiful because of the roots, there we are, the roots of this plant, will now go beautiful in the pot. And the orchid will not stick out of the pot too much, if you know what I mean. Because then we get a dry top layer, which we don't want, of course. So yeah, I think I'm going to do this. It's a nice, I need to get the sticker off. But yeah, I wanted to try this. I think this is a great setup. So let's do that. I'm gonna get my media, and we will repot this one. I don't have to mess around with the roots. I see a few dead ones, but they were already there, and the orchid didn't care. It just kept on growing. So I leave them in. I don't want to mess with it because it really doesn't like messing around, in my opinion. Maybe if you have organic media and you have a little bit of a drier setup, the roots will take better. But because I have a very wet setup, if I damage the roots, rot will set in quite quickly, I think. So therefore, probably in cell watering, orchids are a little bit sensitive, more sensitive to repotting. Probably, I'm not sure, but that would be in my, if you ask me, kind of a logical response of the orchid. Okay, I'm gonna grab the media and I will be right back. So, I did grab my media, and for this one I'm going to use the small pumice. Beautiful, I'm really a big fan of pumice, if you didn't already know. I keep talking about it, but it's such a beautiful media. Preparing it, for me, it's only rinsing it once or twice and that's it. And I have no problems whatsoever for the last year at least, probably longer. So it's maybe a little bit dusty, but every time when I have a new orchid in, I like to flush it in the beginning to get it started to grow. And by that I will flush the dust out. After that I do not flush if it's not needed, as you may know. But yeah, this is beautiful, beautiful media. And I think I can use it because the holes are not that big in this pot, so I probably will stay in there. This one is already has some small pumice in there with some Cintiq. I do not have Cintiq at the moment, but I think I can do without the Cintiq now. But just let's try it and we will see what if we will succeed or not. The other nice thing is, as well, I have a water meter with this one as well. It has it did fit in this pot because the new pot is at the same height. I can still use the same water meter, so I don't have to pull it out. It's in back here, in the back here, but sometimes roots grow in it and around it. But I can leave it like it is. So that's very nice. Let's grab a scoop or something and try to place the orchid in as nice as we can. Okay. I think around here would be nice. It's such a delicate plant, it's so small, so it's very, I don't like to pick it up with it by the bulbs, but yeah. I have a new growth here, I have three new growths here, I have one there, so that makes four new growths already. And this, no, I think that's an old tiny bulb. But we probably will get even more from this area as well. And also we can leave the moss in. I might even put a little layer of plum is in first, so it comes up a little bit higher. It's a little bit deeper than the previous pot. So let's put in some pumice first and let's see. Yeah, I think this is better, a little bit higher. Okay, I'm just gonna keep the plant with one hand, and with the other one I will grab the media and put it around. Fill it all up. Turn it around. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit out of the screen. Yeah, now I want to be as delicate as I can, as careful, because of the new roots. I don't want to break any more new roots if I can. So, let's try to put it in very carefully. So what I just did was I did empty my little scoop thing just next to the new root, so I can now push it, the pumice, around the roots with my fingers, so I can, so there's not a lot of pressure on there, and just easily put it into place, because those root tips are very delicate. So I am being very careful, because I really want them to stay there. And again, I really carefully push it into place. Like this. And there may be a little bit holes there around the roots, a little bit air gaps, something like that, how you want to call it. But that's okay. I leave it. I'm not going to push in the pumice in between those roots there, that section, because I once again I don't want to risk damaging the roots there. So, and I left a, as you could see, a small, where am I? Here am I. Small bit of small room for the top layer of the pebbles. So I'm going to grab some pebbles. And then we are finished. We're gonna water it again. As you can see, I just took the water meter with the plant and put it in its new home. So it was very easy. Sorry for the noises, but this, here we have the pebbles. I probably have a bit too much. Once again, very careful here with those new roots. Most of them were now protected by the pumice, but still, very carefully. Alright, turn it a bit. Whoops, again. And now the moss can grow further into the pot as well. I don't mind the moss, I really enjoy it. To be honest, I really like the look of it. And I have quite some moss growing on in my pot, so I really, yeah, like I said, I really enjoy it. One stone there, and personally I really like the look of the pebbles. Don't know what it is, but I really, yeah, like to enjoy it. So I think this is it. This worked wonderfully well. And like I said in the beginning, this is the first time that I use this setup, but I don't see any problems with it. I think it's a nice fit, and it's not a very deep pot, but it's more a wide pot. And that's often quite hard to find, so I thought, well, I'm going to... I bought three of these setups a few months ago, but I never had... did come around an architect that could use it, but this is the first time. I really think this one will be happy in this spot. But yeah, we will see. So this is the up potting for the Promea Sunlight. So if you have any questions, as usual, please leave them in the comment section below. I just wanted to thank you for being here with me. Thank you as well for all the new subscribers. I see quite some new subscribers on my channel, which makes me really happy. And for now, I can only hope to see you at one of my next videos. Bye-bye.